If you find this video interesting, then please like and share it. Also, leave your comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon for notifications.
Let's start with the three-phase induction motor. Every motor consists of two main parts, a stator that remains stationary and a rotor that rotates continuously. A stator is an outer cylindrical hollow structure. It is made up of multiple laminated steel sheets joined together. Many slots are provided on the inner peripheral of the stator, in which the copper coil is wounded to generate the magnetic poles. Lower the number of magnetic poles, higher is the speed of the motor. The actual stator looks as shown in the figure. Now let's study the rotor. A rotor is a part of a motor which acts as an inner cylindrical core and rotates continuously once the motor is started. It is always kept inside the stator. Depending on the types of windings used, the rotors are categorized in two types: squirrel cage rotor and phase wound rotor. Let's start with squirrel cage rotor. It is mounted on a central rod called as a shaft. It consists of a cylindrical body having multiple slots on it. The copper bars that act as conductors are mounted on these slots. Once constructed, this structure looks like the cage of a squirrel. Hence, the name squirrel cage rotor. The second type of rotor is a phase wound rotor or slip ring rotor. This rotor consists of slotted laminated core of steel mounted on a shaft. The copper winding is placed in the rotor slots, having the same number of poles as the stator. The three brushes or slip rings are connected ahead of the structure as shown. The inner equivalent structure of the three-phase rotor can be drawn considering a shaft as a central axis.
If you find this video interesting, then please like and share it. Also, leave your comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon for notifications.